Welcome to the fifth lecture on centrifugal air compressors. In this session, we will try to solve a numerical problem and introduce some important concept also. So determine the pressure ratio developed and specific work input to drive a centrifugal air compressor having an impeller diameter of 0.5 meter. Impeller diameter, that means outlet diameter of the impeller we take, capital letter D2, that is how we denote it. So D2 is equal to 0.5 meter and it is running at 7000 RPM, that is the rotational speed of the impeller in RPM is 7000. Assume zero whirl at the entry. So that means the whirl component of velocity of air at inlet, that is VW1, that is zero. So that means air entry is purely axial, as we do in most of the cases. This is the usual assumption also, unless we have a pre-whirl component given in the question. So otherwise VW1, we assume that it is zero. Then the total temperature at inlet, that is also given, 288 Kelvin. Total temperature means it is the stagnation temperature at inlet, that is T01, that is 288 Kelvin. So we will try to solve the question. It's a very simple one, direct substitution of the data given. So D2, the diameter of the impeller, D2 is equal to 0.5 meter and the rotational speed in RPM, that is N, is 7000. So from these two, of course, you can find out the peripheral speed or tangential speed of the impeller, U2, that is pi D2 N by 60. So you just substitute, pi D2 is 0.5 meter. N is 7000, that is in RPM, then divided by 60. So we will get 183. So please verify the answer, 183.259. In fact, 2596. So approximately 183.26. 183.2596, that is the peripheral speed or tangential speed of the impeller at outlet. Then now we consider the specific work input relation. So what is specific work input in terms of the impeller speed? So we have a relation incorporating the work input factor and slip factor. So that is psi sigma U2 square, which we derived the other day, psi sigma U2 square. In fact, this is obtained from Euler's expression for Euler's work done. That is VW2 U2 minus VW1 U1. VW1 here is zero. And VW2, that we write from slip factor, because sigma is equal to VW2 by U2. VW2 is sigma U2. So therefore, your specific work input, work done per unit mass, that is VW2 U2 minus VW1 U1, that will become this sigma U2 square, in fact, and that is the Euler's work done. But this is the actual work done. So actual work done means what? The Euler's work done multiplied by a factor called work input factor or power input factor. And this value of power input factor, that is not given in the question. Even slip factor is also not given in the question. So you can assume that this psi, this is a theoretical case, psi is equal to 1, just assume. That we are not considering the frictional losses and all. So psi work input factor is 1 and sigma, that slip factor, that is also assumed that it is 1. So just assume this. But the usual ranges we know very well, that is work input factor, it is more than 1. It is 1.02 to 1.05 usually, and sigma slip factor is 0.9 to 0.94. So that is the range. But here, since it's not given, it's a theoretical case, so we just discard this. So the work done now will become very simple relation, psi sigma 1 into 1 into this U2, 183.2596 square. So simply it is just 183 point 2596 square. So if you take this, in fact that is the velocity square. So you get specific work input, that is the answer in fact, specific work input to drive the compressor. But of course we have with these considerations, work input factor and sigma slip factor, we ignore the effect of those two factors. So WS is equal to, so 183.2596 square, so it is something around 33,584.08 or something like that. So it is, so please verify your answer, 0.08 or something. And this value is the specific work input. This is in joule per kg. Please verify that. But if you want to give it in kilojoule per kilogram, you can give it 33.584 something. So that much kilojoule per kilogram. So that is the specific work input. In fact, that is the answer. Then first part of the answer. Now we have to find out the pressure ratio developed also in this case. So what else is given? The total temperature at inlet is given. So that is T01. In fact, that is the stagnation temperature. So stagnation temperature at inlet, that is given. So stagnation temperature at inlet, that is the total temperature. So 288 Kelvin. And now we will search for the stagnation temperature at outlet, that means at the end of the diffuser or even at the outlet of impeller. So in fact T02 is equal to T03. We explained those things in the last session, and we have the diagram for the compression, actual compression also. But in this case stagnation temperature is given and the pressure ratio is asked. So obviously we will try to find out the pressure ratio in terms of stagnation properties, like means stagnation pressure ratio we will try to find out, because in fact this temperature is given T01, and the flow velocity of air and all we cannot find out. So we cannot get the static temperature now from this quantity. Static temperature we cannot calculate from the given information. So therefore we will write down the pressure ratio in terms of stagnation pressures. So that is what is that? It is we'll write P03, I'll write, because that is the overall pressure ratio we write. P03 divided by P01. Why P03? Because at the end of the diffuser action or at the diffuser outlet it is 03. So we write the overall one, and P03 by P01, so that we need to find out. And after all this P03 and P01, when you consider 1 to 3, so 1 to 3, then it must be what? It must be isentropic. Then only you can use the relation for P03 by P01 directly, like using your thermodynamic concept, T03 by T01 raised to, what is that isentropic relation? P03 by P01 is equal to T03 by T01 raised to gamma by gamma minus 1. Remember, you cannot use this relation for actual compression. So if actual compression is 1 to 3 and that happens to be isentropic, then only you can use it. So why we are considering like that? Because here isentropic efficiency is not available. So we are forced to consider that the compression process is isentropic. So the actual compression process now, so we will consider that is isentropic. Now consider this diagram. This we explained in the last session. That is actual one is 01 to 03 and the isentropic one is 01 to 03 dash. But in this case we cannot consider the deviation of actual compression from isentropic, because we cannot correlate these two, since isentropic efficiency of compression is not available. So therefore what we do is we will assume that the compression is represented by this vertical line in this problem. So here, so in this problem, so we will consider like this. If you draw the diagram, it will be like this in this case here. So I will write specifically here because not always. So when you have a situation like this, then here this is going to be the diagram. Now this one, the actual compression refers to what? It is this point is 0, 1 stag in terms of stagnation properties. Let me mark stagnation state 0, 1, and a diffuser outlet or outlet of the compressor, it is 0, 3. Let me, and the two constant pressure lines through 0, 3, so that we know one is this. So here this is what is this? P03 is equal to constant, that pressure line. And what is the lower pressure? This is P01 is equal to constant. See, I repeat, we assume that the compression is very important. So very important assumption. So here we assume that compression is, the compression taking place in this case, compression is isentropic. In this case, compression is isentropic in this case. So therefore, this is the sketch. So he assumed that entropy is, what is that, constant. So the temperature here, what is the temperature? T03 at the end of compression or diffuser outlet, we have the temperature T03, and here we have the temperature T01. So the relationship now, so we can directly find out this, provided we know these two temperatures T03 and T01. If you have, then P03 by P01, so that you can find out that ratio between these two pressures can be found out. But we have T01, so in this problem we have, what is that, T01 is available, that is 288 Kelvin. Total temperature at inlet or stagnation temperature at inlet is 288 Kelvin. So T03 you need to find out. How do you find out? We have an alternative expression for WS. What is that? WS is equal to Cp into specific work, of course, specific work, that is joule per kg. So Cp into, what is that? T03 minus T01. So specific work output we have already found out by using the other relation. The other relation previously we found out. So that you can use over here. Two alternative expressions for the work input. So 33.584 something, that much kilojoule per kilogram. But of course we want in joule per kg in this case, because I want to substitute Cp in joule per kg Kelvin. So therefore 33,000, this one, so this into 10^3, let me put, and this is in joule per kg. Okay, so Cp into this, and what about Cp? So Cp value is 1005, let me use 1005 joule per kilogram Kelvin. Okay, so if we use this, see T01 is available, T01 is 288 Kelvin, substitute over here, T03 you need to find out. So this we need to find out. What is Cp value? Cp is 1005. So 1005 into T03 minus 288 is equal to this 33,584. So of course, using taking the other Cp to the other side and adding this T01, then so what you will get is T03. The value of T03 you will get easily. So please work out and verify this result. So 317 Kelvin. So this is the stagnation temperature at the diffuser outlet, so outlet of the compressor. Now we will find out, we will find out P03 divided by P01. Only thing is that the pressure ratio is in terms of stagnation pressures, not static pressures. So P03 by P01, that is the pressure ratio. Remember, stagnation pressure ratio we find out. Pressure ratio. If you have a provision to find out static pressure ratio P3 by P1, then of course we will find out that. But in this case, the properties available are stagnation properties. In fact, stagnation temperature at inlet is given. So P03 by P01, that is equal to T03 by T01, because 1 to 3 is isentropic. So 1 to 0, 1 to 0, 3 is isentropic. So use the isentropic relation. What is that isentropic relation? So P03 by P01 is equal to T03 by T01 raised to gamma by gamma minus 1 from our thermodynamic lessons. This, remember, this is applicable for isentropic process. Isentropic process 0, 1 to 0, 3. So we have the temperature 321.417 something divided by T01 is 288 Kelvin, both in Kelvin must be, so raised to gamma by gamma minus 1. So we take gamma is equal to 1.4 for air. So throughout the analysis we assume that air is a perfect gas. Gamma is 1.4, so you substitute this raised to 1.4 by 1.4 minus 1 and calculate this pressure ratio, and you get something around 1.47. so please verify, it's a very small pressure ratio, stagnation pressure ratio. So this is the answer, 1.46, 1.47, around that. Please verify this. This is how we find out. Important thing to remember, here we calculated the pressure ratio in terms of stagnation pressures, number one, and number two, here we assumed that the compression process is isentropic for the lack of additional information. But if isentropic efficiency had it been given, then you can assume that the actual compression is not isentropic, and making use of the isentropic efficiency, you can find out T03. So in such cases we will consider later. There are numerical problems in which isentropic efficiency is given. Now for that purpose we have to get a relation for isentropic efficiency in terms of static temperatures. See, please understand that during the last session we considered the isentropic efficiency in terms of stagnation temperatures, but in this case static temperature. See, the actual points are noted here, and here I omitted the stagnation states 0, 1, 0, 3, but instead we use the original flow state condition at inlet to the impeller 1 and outlet of the diffuser 3, so that the compression deviates from isentropy, similar to the case when we considered the stagnation properties. The same case, only thing is that the stagnation states are replaced by the static 1 and 3, that is 1 to 3 is the actual compression, and 1 to 3 dash is the corresponding isentropic compression, and here the actual compression is 1 to 3. So how do you correlate now? At the end of actual compression, the temperature is static temperature is T3, and at the end of isentropic compression, if had the compression been isentropic, then the temperature would have been T3 dash. Then inlet temperature is T1, both cases. So how do you find out isentropic efficiency in this case? So isentropic efficiency, eta isentropic, is equal to actual work done is in the denominator. So we write isentropic work done, it is a ratio of isentropic work done to the actual work done. But here there is a very important assumption again. If you want to use this isentropic efficiency in terms of this static temperatures, a very important assumption we need to have. What is the absolute velocity of air at inlet? That is V1. What is the velocity of air coming out of the impeller? That is V2. Absolute velocity of air coming out of the diffuser or the compressor outlet is V3. See, what do you know about V2? V2 is greater than V1. It is greater than V1. What about V3? and our effort is to, in diffuser action, the velocity is now again reduced from V2 to V3. So here there is an increase in the impeller for the velocities. In the velocity increases in the impeller, but velocity decreases in the diffuser. And what is the effort? You know, this we will try to make the velocity of air, absolute velocity of air at inlet to the impeller, equal to the velocity of air leaving the diffuser, not leaving the impeller. Remember, so V1, the effort is to be made to get these two velocities equal. What is the velocity? Velocity of air at the inlet to the impeller and velocity of air leaving the diffuser. Remember, we are not talking about the velocity of air leaving the impeller. Leaving the impeller, it is high velocity. V1 cannot be equal to V2, but V1 can be made equal to V3. So if in a problem it is given that the absolute velocity of air at inlet and exit of the compressor, they are same, that means if V1 is equal to V3, if V1 is equal to V3, then in such cases, the actual work done, the work done can be, what is the equation to work done? Now we will write down that expression also. So work done, WS is equal to what? Cp into, what is our equation? T03 minus T01. And in fact, how do you get this? This is actually H03 minus H01. What is H03? So we know that H03 in terms of the static enthalpy and velocity. So we have H3 plus, what is that? We are doing the reverse now. H3 plus V3 square over 2. And what is H01? That is H1 plus V1 square over 2. See this? If what will happen if V3 is equal to V1? If V3 is equal to V1, what will happen? V3 is equal to V1, this part and this part will vanish, because V3 square by 2, and here when you open it, it will be V minus V1 square by 2. So this will vanish. So you will get what? H3 minus H1. See, in terms of simply the difference between the static enthalpies, that will be equal to the difference between stagnation enthalpy at inlet to the between the outlet of the diffuser or outlet of the compressor and inlet to the compressor, then that can be written as that is equal to H3 minus H1. So difference between stagnation enthalpies is equal to difference between static enthalpies. See, this can be used only when the absolute velocity of air entering the impeller, entering the compressor, is equal to absolute velocity of air leaving the compressor, means leaving the diffuser. Okay, so please remember this fact, and then you can write WS is equal to, what is that? H3 minus H1. And in that case, H3, what is H3? It is Cp into T3 minus Cp into T1. So you can write, what you can write? Cp into T3 minus T1. And this is, what is this work done? Actual work done. So we are talking about now actual. But what about isentropic? What about isentropic work done? Isentropic work done, similarly, the isentropic work done, that is the difference between these two. What is that? W. So let me write W isentropic in this case. Similar to this, and if such a case exists, what is that? V1 is equal to V3. Then W isentropic will be Cp into, what is that? I mean, you can write, what you can write? The corresponding expression for the isentropic compression will be H3 dash minus H1. Because 1 to 3 dash is the isentropic compression. So in terms of static enthalpies, you can write. So Cp into, what is that? T3 dash minus T1 dash. Okay. So that is, this is the W isentropic, and this is W actual. So W actual we got. W actual. So this is W actual, Cp into T3 minus T1, and W isentropic is Cp into T3 dash minus T1. T1 is common for both numerator and denominator. So when you substitute over here, Cp is common, so Cp will be cancelled. So what do you get? So T3 dash that is temperature at the end of isentropy compression minus that inlet temperature T1 divided by temperature at the end of actual compression. What is that actual compression? T3 minus T1. So this is the expression we are searching for. So T3 dash minus T1 divided by T3 minus T1. Earlier case, what was our expression? T03 dash minus T01 divided by T03 minus T01. That is when we consider isentropic efficiency in terms of stagnation properties, stagnation temperatures. But this is the isentropic efficiency in terms of static temperature. Remember, this can only be used when this assumption is valid. This assumption holds. What is that? The absolute velocity of air at inlet to the compressor is equal to absolute velocity of air leaving the compressor or at the outlet of the diffuser.